welcome to another episode of Rich Herring's Leicester Square Theatre Podcast. I'm Richard Herring. My guest this week is the lovely Tony Law. That should be interesting. He was very drunk last time I interviewed him. I wonder how it'll go this time. If you are enjoying these, they are free, both on audio and video. If you want to help us pay for the videos, why not go to gofasterstripe.com/badges and buy a one-off badge for however much you think 16 episodes of this would be worth, or a monthly badge for as little as £1 a month, and you can help us make more of these shows. Or just keep watching them for nothing until we have nothing to give you. You can buy this DVD. It's Richard Herring, me interviewing Richard Herring. He's great. Anyway, let's sit back and enjoy Richard Herring's Leicester Square Theatre Podcast at the Leicester Square Theatre with Richard Herring. Welcome to the Leicester Square Theatre for the first time. It's lovely to have you here. Please welcome a man who, if he developed time travel abilities, would only use them for morally impeccable reasons. It's Richard Herring! Thank you very much. Thank you, love. You're much better than last week's audience. Welcome to Richard Herring's Leicester Square Theatre Podcast. I was down at Laser Quest. You know, look, that looks like a guy who plays Laser Quest. I'll just tell you if there's a...
That's not working.
Yes, going now. He plays Laser Quest. He doesn't play. You're square, man. Look at him, he's got a hat and shorts. He's the kind of guy I call... What do you call the Richard Herring's Leicester Square Theatre Podcast?
Rallastapop.
Shit, the cool kids have gone weird. Rallastapop is what it's called now. There's my lovely audience. This is filmed on my iPad. There you go. That's not looking quite nice, don't they? There's loads of them. Weirdly, there's more of you when I look through here than there is in the... There's a lot of ghosts have come today. When I go, there's empty. Whoa. I'm sure they can do something fun with that. Listener Danny Palmer listened to last week's podcast and got in touch with me to say the book that I was thinking about William Herschel was The Age of Wonder. That's what it's called. So check that book out. It's really good. It's about William Herschel. It's about his sister. It's about Davy, who used to drug people with laughing gas. Probably molested them. It was a different time. They kind of wanted it. Women went to him in order to do it. It was a different. I think that's essentially what the Age of Wonder is about. It's about how they got away with their sex crimes. Who else is in it? Loads of cool. There's a Blueness guys. There's loads of great Blueness being killed in it. It's awesome. This is just a book review this has turned into. So it's. Cool. So I'm going to talk to a member of the audience. I'm going to talk to this guy. I'm a bit worried about talking to him. What's your name, sir?
James.
James. That's okay. So you can speak.
I can.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. And what do you do for a living, James?
I'm a writer.
Yeah, it looks like it. What have you ever written in your life?
Real articles.
Oh, yeah, articles. What, on the internet?
On the internet.
That doesn't count, does it? I've got an article... Every week in the Metro, which is a newspaper.
That's a bit bad.
It's a free news. Is it better than yours? Fuck, that's you're in trouble. What is the best article you have ever written about?
Internet safety.
Well, that is an important issue. Andy McCage. Just keep away from Andy McCage. That's the Internet Safety Awards there. Right, so that hasn't gone very well. So I will... But referring to it not going very well has gone well. That's making me an excellent stand-up comedian. That is our job. That is what we have to do. Ian Lee was nice, wasn't he, last week? Did anyone listen to that one?
Yeah, it's good.
We're kind of good friends now. I think we might team up. Be good. But this week's guest is a very different fellow, though with some similarities. He's probably best known for his weekly appearance on the quiz show Does Doug Know? With the woman off the 11 o'clock show. It is Tony Law, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome Tony Law. Tony Law. You're sitting on your microphone. You need to pick that up.
Right out of the gates.
Lovely to have you on, Tony. How are you doing?
Great.
Where did you...
practicing the one word answer.
It could be
good.
Could be a long night. I'm enjoying your gloves.
Not as much as me. But you know, anybody in here who rides knows the reins can get a bit chafy.
Yeah.
So I just keep the gloves on.
Yeah.
Gypsy, I parked her out back there.
Okay.
There's not a lot of room for her in that alley.
No.
She's pretty much just pointing forward. I'll back her out. She's a good horse. In charge of a little, I had a unit of my own over there at the Franco-Prussian War. And when it was done, they couldn't pay me. So I said, well, I'll just keep Gypsy. So I did. You know, there's not much more to that story than that. Gypsy. Yeah.
That's nice. So, what do you remember about the panel show Does Doug Know? That was a different time, wasn't it, Tony?
I remember. It's not the show was. What I remember is the resentment I felt afterwards at the success of everyone else who was on it. I remember that crystal clear. Jimmy Carr, Reg Hunter. Yeah, loads of them just did real good. But I slipped off the rails shortly after that, and everything was fine then. It's hard, tough to get. I'm newly fat.
Yeah.
So it's tough to know how to sit. How do you fucking people do it? You know, I'm mentally great, but physically falling to bits. I don't know how you... Like, that feels rude.
It just inevitably have to slouch after a while. After a little while. I get told off for slouching. But
Up on a horse is no problem because you're sitting straight up. Well, probably I should just adopt my riding position. I've got a good seat. I've been told.
So... I feel the emergency
smoking,
questions...
Smoking, we're rolling, huh?
The emergency questions may be too straight for this. I'm lost. What I found quite interesting about you, Tony Law, investigating you on the internet...
Was my hair?
Yeah, that's an ever-changing...
Been watching a lot of Glen Campbell on the YouTube, and you know what it's like? You get sucked into one of them sinkholes, and you live it! Humperdinck, Engelbert.
Yeah.
The second one, not the first. Glenn Campbell, all the guys. Fucking Elvis Eve, just living the 70s. I watched a roast, you know, Dean Martin's roast?
Yeah.
You get on those of a morning. That's a lot of fun, until Don Rickles gets racist. And then you go, oh, that's why those days were bad.
Well, you have changed a little since the last saw you, when it's more of a beardy top knot affair.
This is my this is my photo negative of my former self. It's all part of the healing process.
We may get
this
onto
is good mental health right here, folks. You too can win. But you know, I think I was telling, you know, I've been watching so many interviews from the 70s, I'm just adopting. Oh, I don't know who I am. Which is exciting, I'm just working on a personality. But you know, I think I was telling you backstage there about how, like, they say when you quit smoking, your lungs kind of heal themselves.
Yeah.
But I can tell you, brain cells don't. Once they're gone, they're gone. So that brings me around to George Jones. That was a morning, just watching George Jones. His IQ dropped to about 80 there. You know George Jones?
I don't know who George Jones is. I'll pretend if you like.
Okay. George.
I'm from the United Kingdom. Who's George Jones? Let's see. Do you know who George Jones is? Is it just me being? Because I don't know much about music. No one knows.
From Country and Western.
Anybody,
we don't like,
anybody know one of his songs? The... No.
We're from the United Kingdom, we do not like
and
country
now,
Western.
Now I've forgotten it too. But a lot of celebrity deaths this
year. There have been. Which one has hit you the hardest? That's one of my...
No, Waylon Jennings is alive. just. like I realize one thing I've learned about myself. I'm terrified of crowds. That's new. And so I've gone blank. I'm a bit... people say I'm a bit like David Bowie of comedy.
Yeah. Which people are these?
But he never... he never tried out fat. No, he didn't. That's one look he didn't do.
That's good. What I find interesting about you on the internet, Tony, is your MySpace page is...
Merle Haggard, that's the one that hit me the hardest.
That's
Merle Haggard. Haggard. Okay.
Your MySpace page still exists. So you're
Does it?
Yeah.
No idea. I forgot about the internet for about 2 years. I did. I completely forgot there was an internet. But I got a meeting with the leader of the internet.
Yeah.
The president, Lord of the internet.
Yeah.
The president, and. We're in talks about a new app I've got.
Okay.
So that's, you know, I gotta keep hush hush about that. It's pretty exciting stuff, though. We're very excited about the direction that's going.
Cool.
It's called. If you need it, need it.
I'd like everyone to pause.
Sounds like Tony's trying out pre-prepared stuff.
Everyone, pause your videos at home and go and find Tony's MySpace page. And see what a difference 9 years can make to a human. You're quite a different fellow back
the
in
internet.
Those days.
Yeah.
Well, and in Does Doug Know, you're kind of clean cut.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good set of wheels.
Yeah. It's a different kind of comedy.
It was a different time, wasn't it?
It was a very different time.
We were all very different back then. Then we all started on the angel dust. And the PCP, all the olden days drugs. Flying. We could all fly, couldn't we? Angel dust and flying. That's what they tell you. That's what my dad said. You watch out. You get over there. Watch out for the angel dust. Oh, no, that was the 70s. He said, if you're going back to the 70s, watch out for the angel dust. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know how to do this.
It's okay. It's good. Oh. It's good. There are no rules.
No.
The only rule is there is no rules apart from listen to what I'm saying and answer the questions. There are no rules. You don't need
to. Man, you got a really big laughter. And I really fundamentally don't understand laughter. So, like, you'd think I should research why that happened. It's just disturbing me. I don't want to know.
Some things we don't want to know. Last time I talked to you, Tony, you were really drunk.
Oh,
on the Edinburgh Fringe podcast.
Just nobody will let me leave it behind.
I'm not sure which was stranger of the two, but it was a very surreal, I don't know if people remember that, it was a quite surreal memory of mine, because you've been out all night with getting drunk, and you'd done your show, and your show had overrun, and then that was our show, and then you came and did my show. And Ian Lavender from Dad's Army was the other guest. That was a surreal experience, I think, for Ian Lavender. I don't think he quite knew. He kind of...
Was that recorded? I'd love to.
Yeah, I tempted him
that.
Onto... It's
actually,
audio.
I can't.
But I tempted him onto the show, and he was quite nervous. And then you came on, and were a force of nature. But I think Ian Lavender, Dad's Army fame...
I feel a bit sick even thinking about those days, the shame and the horror.
So you've given up drinking?
Oh, yeah, a lot.
Yeah.
A lot.
Given up a lot. You had to drink a lot in order to give up a lot, though, right?
Oh, no, I don't want to chat about that. Because if you talk too much about that, it sounds like you're like... It's like if you drive a car in... a combine. I'll use combine. Say if you're driving your combine harvester and you're moving it between fields and you drive it into your neighbor's house and then the next day you go, oh, look at me, I drove it into the neighbor's house, but I'm all right. I'm a hero. No, he still drove the combine into the neighbor's house. And, you know, it's big old wagon full of shame and shit you drag around with you. Guys like you bring it up. I haven't worked out how to talk about it, but, you know, shouldn't. Who cares?
No, well, it's an interesting thing to have moved on in a different direction.
Yeah, no. So, I'm doing a lot of therapy.
Yeah.
It's good. Mostly talk about World War II.
Yeah.
In therapy. It got to me. I was watching a lot of World War II documentaries. I don't know if that was the cause. Some people think it might be like undiagnosed disorder, but I think it was watching too much World War II.
Yeah. There's not much a therapist can do about World War II, though.
Unless they get mad when that's all you talk about.
Yeah.
But I know... I'm sort of like... all the interests I have now are like from when I was 15. The last time, like, those are the only things. I go, what am I interested in? And then they're only the things. So I like ice cream, cavalry gloves. I know they're gardening gloves from Waitrose. But the difference, I got them. I'm a doer. A lot of people go, oh, I can get those gloves and pretend I'm riding horses. But they wouldn't do it. Me? Doer. Get that shit nailed down. Get her done. Buy the gloves. Love ice cream, horses, airplanes, you know, and smiling. All that stuff. I hope that goes some way to answering your question.
It does. Let's give you a bit of background for anyone who hasn't seen your MySpace page. You come from Alberta,
yep.
Canada.
Yeah.
Did you ever visit the Flatiron Museum and Interpretive Centre?
No, where is that?
Is it Lacombe you come from?
Lacombe, yeah. But I left when 26 years ago, so that might be a new one.
I think the Flatiron Museum must have been there for a while.
Yeah, it couldn't
have
been.
That's not something you start up in the 21st century. Let's start a Flatiron Museum. I don't even know what a Flatiron is, really.
I don't know what we're talking about right now. I left Lacombe when I was 17 in Canada when I was 19, so I don't know much about it.
No.
Mike Wilmot goes around Canada going, hey, you heard of Tony Law? And all the Canadian cops are going, no. And Mike says, you must really sucked in Canada. But I've never done a gig in Canada.
Right.
I came here when I was 19. So have a look around. I'm on a gap year.
Yeah.
From going back to finishing off high school.
Your family is still waiting for you. And did you come straight into comedy when you came to the UK? Well, you did a bit of comedy in Canada, didn't you, before you came out?
No.
No, I'm just...
No, I did theatre sports in high school.
Right.
Oh, yeah, tell us about that, Tony.
Yeah, I'd like to know.
No, it took me a long time, because I didn't think that's something farming kids could do.
Yeah.
I thought you had to be a city folk. So it took me a long time. I have low self-esteem. And it took me a long time to get confident. And then I found a little trick. And it destroyed my life. And luckily I kept a lid on it till I was starting to build a career. And I thought, here's the time to press the button. Who wants a meeting? I've said too much. Hey, next week can we get someone less sherry? What is this, the hug hour? I'm getting to know myself, Richard.
Yeah.
I gotta be honest with you, I don't like what I see. I don't like who I think I am. There's no levels to me anymore. Just looking right at me going, I think I might even be a little right wing. So I was totally like, let's leave the euro for the longest time.
Then the guys who are like doing the talking for the leaving, just I can't be associated with it. Like he's, you gotta be able to be stood at a do and be okay seen with that guy.
Yeah.
But some of the yip yap coming out of those fellas, no. Hey, will this be broadcast after?
This will be
I want to hedge my bets. Can I?
This could be the thing that swings it one way or the other, Tony.
It's kind of just. This what got me mad? Work. What got me mad with Europe was some Belgian had a wolf dog in Highgate Woods bit my dog, and so I apologize. I don't know how to assert myself. I need to learn that, and that's what my therapist tells me. For the sake, I laughed to reassure her. I was going, dogs will be the way they are. But that's not what I was thinking. This is where me thinking I'm a horrible person comes in. Because all I was thinking of is you, European scum. Get out of our country. I'm not really, all she had to do was just go, oh, sorry. That's it. Nothing. Because I'm like, oh, sorry, oh, animals, don't worry about it. She didn't say sorry. That's all, because we never mean sorry at all. It just means let's not fight. Or it just, so I, oh, we're leaving. But I didn't say any of that.
No.
I just walked away, and my dog still doesn't look at me the same. Do you think he's just kind of like, oh, dude, just stand up for me.
The Brexit people might just be sending people out pretending to be Belgians and making them do awful things. So
yeah, I thought German. Yeah. I don't know why. Belgian, German, Central European.
Yeah, well, the Belgians have...
But then I really love... I love all the people I know from there.
Yeah.
But that's not enough. There's far more I have no idea about. I don't know these people. I don't like them.
Yeah. You've given us a lot to think about when we go out and vote tomorrow. I think people will be going out to vote
tomorrow.
So we'll have to consider all the things you said there and weigh those up.
I've got a few bits in my show.
Yeah.
Here at next month at the Edinburgh Fridge Festival, that have got I cover both bases in or out.
Okay.
But let's face it, we'll stay in, won't we?
I don't know if we will.
I don't know, but
come and see. We'll know though. We'll know.
Yeah, when you come to Tony Law's show at the Assembly Rooms. Yeah, just plugging that in there.
What's it called, Tony?
It's Tony.
Tony. It's called Tony. Tony Law in Tony.
Tony Law, a law unto his elf, what welcome. Because I've been learning a thing or two about marketing and that type of deal. And what I've learned is what you want to give them a long title. And the longer they're saying your title, the more they're thinking of you. That shit's sinking in, and they're more likely to come. So they go, oh, Tony Law, law unto his elf, what, welcome? And then they're going to say it again. And if they say it three times, they're in the door. It's a shame you can't see this, because I do some excellent facial expressions at the end of that.
Okay. Some people can see you, there are cameras, there you go. To make sure you do it towards the camera.
I'm just loving my hair right now. I found some hairspray backstage.
Yeah.
I tweeted that, and then someone probably in here said, did you steal that from the Leicester Square Theater? Yes. And I hope it's not yours. It's really good stuff, though.
Yeah, if people like to leave things lying around. Stuart Lee left his toothbrush backstage.
That sounds...
Gonna regret that. So that's all I saw.
Yeah, what are we gonna do with it?
So I'm gonna ask you some emergency.
Sneer at it.
I'm gonna ask you some emergency questions.
We'll ask it for a photo.
I don't think there's ever been.
When it's with its family. That was funny. Me and my wife and our kids and him and I was with Bridget Christie and her husband.
Yeah.
And it sort of summed up what kind of a person I am. It's like, some guy comes up to get
wants a photo of Stu, and he goes, no, I'm with my kids. And he's up, but me, I'm going, and then he asks me, and I go, sure. So that's like kind of like my dog was saying, you need to get some assertiveness and stop selling down a river, your dog.
It's just, that's being polite, though, Tom. That's
mind you, my dog, you know what I was thinking? I was thinking, I'm going to train him and abuse him till he becomes a super fighting machine and go back there. And fight them back to Europe. That's what I actually thought. I probably shouldn't tell people that. I should probably. That's what I should talk about in therapy. I need a notebook and like write down stuff. Because as always, you get these great ideas like when it's too late. Damn it. I still feel good though when I come out. It's not always World War II.
No.
No, we talked about. Well, we talked about Persia last time. Mm-hmm. And I could just see the wheels turning, trying to work out what's going on. What does Tony mean about that? I'm just like interested in Persia right now. Yeah. I read all of Tom Holland's books.
Okay.
And I'm on Persian fire right now. Went to the British Museum with him.
Yeah, oh, did you?
Yeah.
You're a big friend of the, you know, Mary Beard, don't you?
Well, I was, and then I was off the rails. I don't think she wants to be seen with me.
Oh, really?
And I don't blame her.
Oh.
No. She's gone from strength to strength.
She likes a drink, Mary
Old
Beard.
Old mares. Anyways, yeah, so Persia.
Yeah.
Cyrus.
I don't know much about Persia.
You know, I used to, but it's
Iran
just,
now.
It's gone now. Great horse. Medes, yeah, the horses. Horse. Well, they adopted a lot of the Babylonian culture.
I'm very happy to talk about history for the rest
actually,
of the...
Actually, Tajikistan. Now, there's where I ended up
right.
On the device. Just reading about Tajikistan.
Yeah.
Wonderful people.
I want to
Central Asia. I'm all over that right now.
Yeah, I'm very. This
fucking
is something I don't know about.
Confusing in there. Like, try and visualize all the countries on, like in your mind. Close your eyes and go, where is everything? Am I right? It's tough to put it all. Like Kazakhstan, that's easy. And then underneath you got Tajikistan and you got Turkmenistan over there. Then you got the Caspian Sea. Caspian Sea, just stick it in there, going. That's what the Caspian Sea. I do impressions this year's show.
Yeah, it's good.
You should see my impression of the sun. I'm not going to do it now. But, yeah, no, the Tajikistan people are wonderful people. They descend from both Persian and Turkic peoples. It's a wonderful mix up there.
Tony,
I'd like to go on the Silk Road. I'd like to go on the. I'd like to ride a horse all the way down the Silk Road. All the way down the Silk Road. Whoa. And just like with a bag of pepper. That's my fucking dream. That's my dream. It's just me and a bag of pepper taking it to Rome. In my car, I bought History of the World and 100 Objects.
Yes. Yeah,
Neil McGregor.
Yeah.
British Museum. And and like you know when you listen to the series on Radio 4, it's just a short bit each time. But when you're on a 9-hour drive to Dundee and back, I did a gig at Dundee. And now that I can drive, I just drive everywhere. Go, oh, I missed this. And so you listen to. I only got through 9 of the 20 CDs. But like after each bit of information, it comes the sting, like that. And so it's like you spend probably 4 hours of your drive running. So I'm going to put that in the show this year.
Okay.
And that'll really, like, instead of, like, having a good 45 with 15 filler, I'm just going to have a tight 30 and just pack it out with that sting from History of the World and 100 Objects. And it gives the routine time to percolate.
Yeah.
You know, time for people to really think about it and go, no, that wasn't funny. It was, that was just the cadence he used. He just did it with the right pace. Oh, Tony, yeah, so I, you know. I'm just, you know.
Tony, when...
I'm probably going to wreck comedy this year.
Yeah. No,
That's my goal. I'm going up there. In a good way. I'm going to wreck it.
Oh, okay.
Because I've been playing. It's been an unfair playing field all these years. You know, I've been going up to the Edinburgh Fringe, and everyone's all like, "Oh, working on their laptops, getting the shows ready." You know, being all living in the moment, sober, no mental illness. Where I'm now, me, a healthy tone. Pow! Just gonna destroy comedy. Just gonna wreck it. Boom! What happened? Festival's over, guys! Tony brought a healthy show up. It's over! Let's all go home. But you got a good university degree, so you'll be all right. All you guys with your degrees, you should be getting good, productive jobs.
Yeah. I don't remember very much of it as my knowledge of Persia.
More than I do about the Flatiron Museum.
Yeah. It sounds like a good museum.
Macomb.
I went to the Shipwreck Museum in Charleston in St. Austell in Cornwall. It's quite a poor museum.
Your boat is good at... that was off the back of what?
Well, we're talking about the Flatiron Museum. The Shipwreck Museum in Charleston. It's like a museum of a museum, because it hasn't changed since 1974.
Oh, I love that. That's so adorable. That's,
yes, the
went to Bignor, you know, where the fish... you know the Roman villas with the mosaics down in the woods? Fishbourne, there you go. I was there the other day. Go to a museum with a 7-year-old and they have a camera. It's just, and the museum, old bits written about steps. Oh my God, it's just a little tear in your eye the whole day. Wasn't a whole day, there's not enough. There's only so much imagining you can do. And then you start to thinking, wow, it was freaking only the top 2% were doing all right. See, that's how, I think we view with the end of the Romans in Britain the wrong way.
Yeah.
You know, I think, you know, because it's like, oh no, and then the Anglo-Saxons, I think the Anglo-Saxons are already here mostly. They're already there was no big, it's just the structure went, and the top 2% who owned the big villas, they just, you know, them,
yeah.
They just, you're not in control anymore, and everyone just parceled it up and started their own little farms. Mm-hmm. It was a time of freedom. Yeah.
It's possible.
Super possible. Interesting.
It is.
Up
it's
here.
A war-
I'm not, you know,
it's
I'm learning warning. About social situations.
It's a warning to the... This is how... But that's what happens all the time, Tony, is that people get very rich. They get a bit too rich. They don't give a fuck about everyone else.
And then they bury it in the ground.
And everyone else goes, oh, hold on, these people are cunts.
Yeah.
Let's overthrow them, and then we'll become the cunts.
Yeah. But nowadays, they got big, like... That it was easier to bury stuff for us to come
it was,
and
yeah.
find their treats. Like a little salt, the pepper shaker. That was the episode that was on the other day. But finding all that good stuff. Lovely floors, left some fantastic floors.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure everyone else with their little farmsteads just had a bit of dirt. So they had that.
Yeah.
But you know, the... Good times.
Have you ever tried sushi, Tony? It's nice, you should give it a go.
Well, interestingly enough,
yeah.
I was on the deck of one of those treasure ships with Judy. Admiral.
From Richard and Judy?
And I don't know, Judy, it don't matter. He was he had no testicles.
Okay.
And I think that's why the emperor trusted him. Interestingly, you won't find a lot of teak in China to this day from all the... Cut down all the teak, very strong wood. That's how they could build such large treasure ships. Anyways, long story. We stopped in Japan on the way out. Yeah. We're heading over to India and down to... that's when I first had sushi. Okay. I don't like it.
Wait a minute.
I always have the katsu curry.
Yeah.
I'm a katsu curry guy. It's like having a burger at another type of restaurant.
I don't pay attention when I'm eating out. I'm more like fuel, get her in. I know. A lot of people are cooks these days, aren't they? Everyone's all into cooking. Pepper was very important to the Roman people, you know? Pepper. But 120 ships every single day would go down out of the Red Sea towards India. Pepper, full of pepper. When the Visigoths, Ostrogoths, I forget which of the Goths, maybe it's the Vandals, I don't remember. But when they wanted to get them out of Rome, the main thing was they wanted a ton of pepper. So I just got my mind all over pepper right now. If I don't think about pepper, I just think about ice cream, and that's no good. You know, I can't even eat ice cream in front. I'm not allowed to eat ice cream in front of the kids anymore. Because it's just like, it's so depressing. That's other people looking at me eating ice cream. This is me eating the ice cream. I'm so distant. It's like I'm not there. I'm immersed. Oh, it just transports me. Oh my God, ice cream.
I'm just
I didn't eat it for about 15 years.
It's nice. I'm looking forward to writing the blurb for this show, I tell you. It's can't wait to pick out just what happened. I've no idea. It's good. It's good. If you could have like a law named after you for immortality, or a disease, the Tony Law disease, like the Lou Gehrig disease, or a law. Is there a Tony Law law? That isn't even a pun, actually, by the way. That's that came back organically.
A law?
Yeah, if you had a law. My law is if you go to the gym, whichever locker you choose, when you come back to it, someone will be using the locker right next to the one that you use. It's just a truth. So you'll have to change very close to another naked man. Even if the locker you choose has no one around it when you choose it, when you come back from the swimming or the gym.
God, that's
look
horrible.
How true it is. The audience is so...
You go to the gym?
Yeah.
Sorry, I don't want to be one of those people, but... I don't want to be one of those guys, but like, what are you doing in there? Oh, what a dick, right? See, I don't know how to be. I don't know. I'm an asshole. You should have seen me when I was... Oh, you did.
When you... It's all right. If you're fat, you're allowed to take the piss out of fat people's only. So
the only law would be don't bully, but that might be a law.
Don't bully.
Yeah.
After you've just done a joke about me being fat.
Yeah, I know. I know. I breaking the law. Yeah. No. I those laws are, you know, to me, don't be a dick is what I say to myself every other day.
It's a good thing to. Good
thing to you know, because I still like to leave those ice cream windows open. A liter a day there for a while. It's almost like it was a replacement.
Fucking
love it. And not all the fancy, like I'm a vanilla guy and I know all the vanillas. What you hear, Derbyshire, North Derbyshire, that's where you get an ass. Get a nice ice cream out there. McKay's up in Scotland, that's a great pure vanilla. Great, you don't want it too cold though. Not too freezy.
Are you aware of the website tonylawexhaust.co.uk?
Yeah, I think that used to be mine.
Is it?
Because back in the days when I used to look in the internet for things about me, that was my website, and I lost that. I've lost a bunch. Anything Tony Law ends up being like tools, exhausts, and then there's Tony Law, the Japanese photographer. He don't like me. And I don't blame him. Oil and water, him and me. I find his stuff just stodgy, not creative. Tony Law exhaust, good work.
Well, I saw that come
excellent
up.
Excellent exhaust.
I thought, that's an odd name. It's apt, but it's an odd name to give.
Mufflers. Well, you need a good muffler.
When you die, Tony, and you go to heaven, as I'm sure you will, what age would you like to be when you're in heaven?
93.
Really?
Yeah.
What if you don't get to 93 on Earth? Do you want to be...
No, no,
forward?
I will.
Okay. Okay, sorry.
No, I'm going to be 93.
Yeah.
Like my granddad.
But you'll be 93 when you die, but when you get to heaven, you don't have to be 93 anymore. You could choose any age.
I don't know if I'm going to... If there's enough time to get back into the heaven. You know? It's a big hill to climb.
There is.
But, no, I'm happy to just die.
Yeah.
That's, like, 93, you're done. It's like the thought of heaven, a heaven. Ooh, nightmare.
I agree.
What, more? Jeez, done my best to keep it tight, you know? Keep a nice, tight 90. My granddad's, no, I don't know, just not a great, he smoked since he was 8.
Right.
And then they made him quit smoking to go into hospital, and he's 92. And grandma said, that'll kill him. And it did. You see the stock I'm from. But then my wife pointed out a good point. She said, yeah, well, they were poor Northern Irish farmers, and they grew their own, they ate vegetables their whole life.
Yeah.
So they were pretty much, you're not. Yeah. You know, a bit of that bouncy broccoli, but...
Yeah, I worry about the same thing.
I'm running out of steam. Let's just chill out a bit now.
We can chill. It's a very long night for me, so you know, I'm happy to chill out.
This is super late for me. I get up at... Here's the problem.
Yeah.
I'm up at 5 every day right now.
Yeah.
Like, because I'm having these good sleeps. Phenomenal. Like, people out there have lived a good life. That's good, isn't it? Where you just ping. Wow, I am well rested. And let's see. There's no one to talk shit to. So do all that. And that. So now I got all these things, but I don't know what to do with it. Like, I don't know what it is I do. So that's difficult, you know, because now I've got to like edit before
yeah, so
I go
you're
and do a show. So
you're writing,
I don't know what is a thing and isn't.
Yeah.
Because I'm not sure what it is that's been happening all this time. So I just put that in, and then that might just be a sound. But if it gets a laugh one night,
even just mentioning that it was there, that got a laugh from that lady. So just even saying.
So that'll probably be in now.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, like, because there's no jokes.
No,
there's
I was going to...
I would thought that would just turn up.
I was going to try and describe what you did to people, but, I mean, I think this
podcast... Oh, don't you hate that when you
yeah.
get...
Yeah, this podcast where he does
though,
it.
No, you're like, and, like on a local presser or something, and they say, well, tell us about the show. Oh, God. And I have to make sure either the kids or my wife are within earshot because I get so embarrassed of the shit I say. Well, it's, I just say, it's, this one is about light.
Okay.
But that's not enough, you see. And then when you sort of add to it, it just goes off. And then, like, especially when you got to give your 50 words or whatever in March.
Yeah.
It's very good advice to go, like, revisit that and then see if some of that can be in what it ends up being.
But that's only 50 words, Tony. That's not going to help you, right?
No.
You can say them very slowly. A minute a word.
My plan is, I'm going to go up to the festival. My aim is to win an award.
You've come close to winning an award. I always think you have won an award.
I won some, but...
Yeah, but like, you got nominated for the Edinburgh show a few years ago.
Yeah, because I love the competition side of it. I thrive on that. I like being judged.
It's my favourite thing.
I do. I used to not like it because I was a sissy, but now I'm just embracing it. Come on. Let's compete. Let's wreck it. Let's destroy comedy. It's gone all clunky, isn't it?
No, it's fine. It's good. This is the...
the lull.
There's a little lull.
It feels like then my, one of my shows right now. That middle bit. Oh, how are we going to get out of this? Because I'm very much... I reflect people too much, you know? That's what, and now, so everyone's... And I'm like, yeah, we're all kind of, oh, We're all drifting off, thinking about other stuff. I try and encourage that, actually. People just drift off. Like, maybe if anyone does come to my show in Edinburgh, just bring something to do in the middle. Because, you know, who can focus for an hour?
It's hard.
That's why it's great on tours. You do two, you can do a 45 and a 45.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
Yeah. Yes. Let me ask you this. Would you rather date a woman who was a 6 foot tall vulva or a woman who, instead of having a vulva and a vagina, had another tiny woman just between her legs, just a complete woman?
Wow, that was a Richard Herring question.
Thank you. I thought you'd enjoy it. You can ask me any subsidiary questions you like.
If someone else asks a question, anything like that, you just say, oh, he's stolen that from Herring. That's his market. That's his weird, right up to the edge of being sexist. But he seems nice.
It's the opposite of sexist, because it used to be a penis and a man with a man. And now it's unsexist because it's a woman. It's as far away from sexism as you could get.
It's your cheeky, interesting mind.
Yeah.
So it's like a woman is a penis.
No, I don't mean
ridiculous. No, that's not sexist at all, is it?
A woman is a 6 foot tall vulva. What she has is some fake arms.
Well, she's not a vulva.
That are on her shoulders. She's a vulva. She's trying to disguise herself as a human being by drawing a face on their clitoris, and she's put some false arms.
You go out with her for sure, because you could dress up, you could play hide and seek.
Could hide in there, couldn't you? If there was a Belgian coming with a dog, you could jump inside.
Warm and a wonderful place, you know?
Where's Tony Law? All I can see is this massive twat.
Hi, guys! And that fits perfectly.
Yeah.
All right. Joke.
Otherwise, just chuck one in. Just chuck one in. That's all I do in my shows. I chuck one in every now and again. That's all I do. Just one every now and again.
I can't listen to you now without, like, what does he mean? What do you mean by chuck one in?
I'll ask you another question. There's definitely a new good one for you.
Sound like Craig.
Do you ever worry, Tony, that you have already lived your life and are now in a care home with Alzheimer's disease?
You wrote that already?
Yeah.
That's not based on what's happened so far.
This is a general question. And what you perceive as reality is just a distorted memory of the first time this happened. Yes or no? I want a yes or no answer.
That's written down?
Yeah. Because I'm one.
Wow, you are clever. I knew I'd need these glasses.
There it is. It's in my book.
Do you ever worry? Oh, my God. What was the question again?
No, it's not important.
No. No, I don't worry about that.
What do you worry about?
Oh, you know, your loved ones.
Yeah.
You know, all the normal stuff.
Spend a lot of time worrying about.
I worry about my orcas.
Your orcas.
I got 9 orcas that can't find work right now. You know, I worry what kind of a life I've left them. When I got him in the 70s, nobody had a problem with super sad, depressed orcas. SeaWorld, hire him out. Shamu, he pretty much he worked every day of his life. I worry about... You know, the normal stuff like that. You worry about your kids, don't you? And running out of natural resources.
That's a bad one.
That's a terrible one.
Yeah.
You don't want to spend... New scientist. I jumped the aisle there. I got a new scientist. Actually, I was booked up. Robin, booked me for one of the science comedy crossover shows with Coxie and the guys. And I thought I'd brush up on all science. The week before, then I just do a little brush up on science.
You need more than a week. Fucking loads of it. And I just looked at that wall, like that, it's like a, what's that, Game of Thrones? Like that wall on that, that was what I was looking at. And I just went, nah, I'm gonna go there. There's no wall that way. And I should watch Game of Thrones so I can really weave that in. But no, anyway, New Scientist just saying, yeah, no, oh geez, we run out. We can't fire things back up again without stuff.
Yeah.
Anyway, worry about that. And then you just think, ah. 90, by the time I'm 93, we'll still have some. We'll top off a few more mountains. Be fine.
They'll find. I think they might find some a way around it.
That's what keeps it going, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's people thinking that. That's what keeps people going. Yeah, no, we'll work it out. I don't think we will. Well, I mean, I won't. You know those. Those guys over at the Large Hadron Collider, those are our best bet. I don't know what they're up to, but I'm happy they're there, and I think good for them.
Yeah.
You know, keep going, fellas. And ladies. Richard. Keep it going, whatever it is you're up to. I got faith in you.
Yeah.
Okay. You ever been to the Small Hadron Collider? I knew a guy who worked on it, and I talked him into letting me take my scooter in there. It's a smooth ride, let me tell you. So, and again, I hope that goes some way to answering.
It does go a long way to answering. I don't know why I'm
bothering. Is this the point where all the guests go, oh, I'm sorry, I'm fucking it up?
No, you're not. It's good. It's really good.
No,
it's
I wasn't impossible. Gonna say for me.
No, no. Well, Ian, if anyone's to blame, it's me.
No, you're wonderful at this. This is a hard thing to do because I couldn't talk to comedians like you do. You know what I mean? It's like I just don't know how to be with. It's just wow.
I think you should do it, Tony.
What about you? Well, you know, like, oh my God, I can't even interview myself.
No. Well, if you want to see me trying to do that, then you can buy. That's me interviewing myself. That's a load of
what's
stuff.
What's that?
That's a load of
stuff. Oh, talking
about penises.
I saw that.
Yes. Well, you know, it was a very successful show.
That's not. Classic herring. There going. Whew. You know, you're not that. That's. Dented my confidence.
No, sorry.
You know, that doesn't sort of fire you up for the next phase of the
next,
show, does it?
Next 3 hours.
It's like, fuck, really? Oh, so ooh. Tony. bloody hell, what did I...
I think I've got everything out of here that I can. I'm gonna give you. It's good. We're gonna have to go off book. if you had to take, I've got a thing called Desert Island Dicks. I'll do it for you.
If you had to take
eight Richards to a desert island, which eight Richards would you take with you?
Burton? No, I wouldn't anymore.
Why? What did he do?
No, I can't be around people who drink. And it's not because, because most people who drink are cool and normal and all that. It's just that I can't, I don't know how to gauge what people mean. You know, because everyone's just off. So you don't know whether people are lying or not. It's weird, because I was the one. So I never developed that being able to read. So someone goes, hey, good to see you. And I go, oh, what do they mean by that? So not Burton.
Okay. That's one down. Who isn't gonna
be? No, I don't know, I could study him. Richard Burton. Richard Coeur de Lion.
Oh yeah, it's a good one.
Just ask him what I'd embarrass myself. I'd probably ask him a lot about Saladin. And I'd ask him for my horseback. And that's what it was like in those days, the horses. Crusades, by the way, not as glamorous as you think. Mostly rooting around in fields for something to eat.
truffles a lot. You know, people like truffles, but not when that's all you have. And water, I drink more water. So Richards.
Yeah, Richards the first.
I've never liked many Richards.
No, it's hard. There aren't many nice
Rich. Can Richard be their surname?
Yeah.
Maurice Richard.
I don't know who that is.
He's a ice hockey player from the 50s.
Okay.
Played for the Montreal Canadiens.
Okay.
The Rocket Richard.
Is that the same guy?
Richard Bellevue. Bellevue?
Going for Canadian.
No, that's Jean Bellevue. I've got that wrong. Guy Lafleur.
Let's broaden out. Let's broaden out to just anyone with a name. Which eight people?
Richie Rich.
Richie Rich. That can count as two, if you
Rich.
Like.
I would just ask him what it's like in a cartoon.
Yeah.
You know, I think that'd be good. Rich. Richard. Oh man, you know what? As soon as this is done, I'm gonna know.
It's a really hard question.
A hard one. Richard Herring.
Everyone gets to three. You can't say I'm a luxury Richard. You get me. I'm like the Shakespeare Richard. You get me.
I'd have you for Richard and
I just wanted. I think I might leave this.
Rick Law, my cousin.
Yeah, he can come.
I never really knew him. You know, I don't really know him at all. Oh, my cousin Gary. Yeah. Law and Arnold. Just for the facial hair. These are always homages. Each facial hair setup is usually a cousin from one of the lesser successful farmers in the family. Always had an array of different facial hairs. That's pretty much a marker if you want to see who's going to make it in farming, is the ones with the sort of very sober facial arrangements. Those guys. Success. Like a mustache maximum. But the big sideburns or the one in the mustache like that, those guys aren't, you know, they've got other things on their mind. Cowboy shirts, tight jeans, drinking. Yep, not farming. So, you know what you should do?
What?
Have you ever. Ever in Canada and you get out on a farm and get a snowmobile and ride out right into the middle of a field, like in between, so that usually it's 2 miles by 4 miles, so you get right out in the middle and then just turn it off in the middle of winter and all you can hear is the engine cooling down, and then after a couple of minutes it goes quiet and you sit there and it's perfect, complete, frozen, 45 below zero, cold. And then that's when your mind just sort of cracks and you're never the same again because you realize how utterly alone you are. And no matter how much you love and try, that's how it will always be. You will die alone. And there's nothing you can do to change the size of the universe and your insignificance and the crushing reality of that moment. When you're 8, and then you do it again the next year when you're 9, like, and you reinforce that will trigger. So anyways, I don't think that's what you asked. I was just trying to keep talking.
I know, it's good.
Just that thought popped into my head just there.
It was a good thought.
Yeah, and I thought I'd just start talking like this. What was Richards?
Yeah.
That's the thing. So that's what's got my mind going all these other places is because the Richards has stressed me out.
Yeah. It's hard. No one can do it.
Richard.
I don't really care.
Like,
really
all the bad Richards are coming. I care now.
Yeah.
But the bad Richards, you're like, I wouldn't want to go. But that Richard's in my head.
Yeah.
I don't even want to say it. Richard. There's not many Richard, Kings, was there?
There were three.
What was
Richard the first, Richard the second, Richard the third.
Oh yeah, Richard the third. Oh God, I knew it. That's helped Leicester City, didn't he?
Yeah.
He won it for them. I knew it. As soon as they dug him up. That's it. Lester's going to win the soccer ball. Love the soccer ball. Read it in the Guardian so I can talk it.
Yeah.
Don't like watching it, though. Oof. Wow, that is the same thing, isn't it? A lot. So, Richie Rich. There's Rich, just make up a Richard.
Yeah.
There's him.
Well, there was Gary Law. he was Richard. Arnold Law.
Rick. And
Rick from The Walking Dead.
Richard Linklater.
Yeah.
That would have eaten me up all day. Oh, Richard Dawkins, of course.
Yeah.
Oh my. I actually got I got too nervous at another one of Robin Ince's gigs.
Yeah.
He gets cool people, doesn't he?
He does.
And I got stage fright. I just couldn't bear. Because I knew I was just going to say a bunch of stupid stuff.
Yeah.
So Dawkins, just I got a way in now. Oh, I remember at a gig for Ince. That's what I say to Dawkins.
Your way
How did it go for you? I think you killed it.
Your way in is to go, if I was to take a desert island with 8 Richards, you would be one of them. That I would think, it would take me a while to think of you, but then you were definitely, once I thought of you, I think you're definitely
He's
in
super
there.
Smart. He'd know that, like, at that moment, I wouldn't have been able to think of it. So what was the next one? What about buy bars? I'd only take one of them.
Okay.
I'd only know the one. Buy bars, the Mamluk Sultan. Saw off the final crusaders. Yeah. And the Mongol horde.
Yeah.
Which is not nothing. I think it's buy bars. I don't know, I only read these words. I don't know if I'm pronouncing them right. I should be.
It's interesting. Are you regretting wearing those gloves now? It's quite hot up here.
No.
Okay.
No, because I'm getting there's a lot of space up in there.
Okay.
So there's air moving through it.
Okay.
So I'm that extremity is airing it out. But I can start to hear mumbling in the crowd now, and I think we're losing it.
We're losing some. Some of them
and
are wondering
I don't
about
blame
their,
them.
Some of them wondering about their trains home. I'll try and get one more question in. This could take 20 or 30 minutes. And then we'll... have you ever seen a ghost?
No.
Oh. Well...
I've traveled through time and I've never seen a goddamn stupid ghost. Jesus Christ. Have you?
No, there aren't any.
What did you say?
There aren't any ghosts.
No.
Yeah.
What is?
Doesn't mean people don't see them, though, Tony.
Well, they see. What they don't see in anything. They got a little wire up there. Just gave a little trip.
Yeah.
I know all about that. But at least it didn't give in to the ghost. Hell, I don't know why I talk like that. That was a fun question. More
Thank
like
you.
That.
Have you? This is a great one for you. I can't believe I haven't asked this to you. Have you ever seen a Bigfoot? When you were in Canada, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've seen. No, I've seen what people think is a Bigfoot,
okay.
Which is a black bear, far away.
Okay.
That's what. And they get up on their hind feet to grab some stuff out of the trees sometimes because they're great at they love standing up and looking, especially grizzlies. But black bears, you see them all the time. I have fond memories of driving into Banff National Park, and in the spring there'd be a queue of people getting in. They'd be coming down the hills, and you know, out of hibernation, super hungry, and they knew dumb tourists who were just handing them stuff, and they. And they'd love the heat of the engine of your car, and they'd just lie on some people's car. They couldn't move because of the bear. And then you'd see some of the worst parenting ever, where someone would put, like, honey on their child's hand while the bear's licking it. Because they're not super huge, so they look like a massive dog. And they're like, taking a picture. And I remember being with my buddies in, we were like 16, all...
I go, oh man, how's this gonna pan out? That bear's gonna eat his hand, man. Oh, don't honk the horn. And then there's a long conversation about the ethics of like, should we honk? If we don't honk the horn and he bites him, then we are partly responsible for that child losing his arm. But what if we honk the horn and that instigates the bite? Let's just let it unfold. What's the Star Trek, or the directive from Star Trek? Just let it happen. Anyway, so that's been a fun memory.
That's good.
That makes up for the silence bit.
Well, it's very late at night. I've got up at 5:30 this morning. I've got a like a tiny stupid human being in my house.
And I got mine are bigger now.
Yeah.
And get up and try and avoid any homework questions. There's seven now, so they're starting to our educational levels are crossing. And I need them to look up to dad. So and then I take my dog out.
Yeah.
For a long walk to the park.
Yeah, my wife wants to get a dog. I'm not sure.
Well,
then because I'll end up walking it. Like, do you like walking?
Yeah, well, it was my idea to get the dog.
How was it?
Yeah, he was my last. He was the best bad decision I have ever made. So he's from the time of the descent. He's from the dark times, where I wanted to get a big dog, but then when I got healthy and sorted out, the dog just. He's still there and really growing. And now he's enormous. He's as large as he was said to be in the beginning. And he takes a lot of work. No, I love him. I adore him. He's like a therapy. He's black.
Yeah.
Of course.
Has he ever been mistaken for a Bigfoot? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, he's very bear-like.
Yeah.
Big old head on him. Like a bit like Newfoundland German Shepherd mix. It's a lot of dog there. A lot of dog. Whole lot of dog. And I love him. I kiss him. Now, someone I was watching a gig the other day saying that in some other cultures, like, he was asking them, what are the negative things people say about our culture? And one of the ones is, like, that we have sexual relationships with our dogs. That we're all like, we love dogs. That was somebody said from, that's what the joke is about us. I was like, so? if I had to, if he wanted it, like I wouldn't, because it's like weird for him, that's his rights to not. But I love him, I just, whatever, I love him. So,
Yeah. I knew we'd get to the gold if we don't far enough. I knew you'd hang yourself eventually.
That's me just busting it down.
Yeah.
No, but so dogs actually are quite in most cultures. Oh, we've co-evolved for 40,000 years. What's not to love? We feel each other, we're in sync. So get a dog. Did you have dogs growing up?
No.
Oh, maybe don't get one. She'll just be bad at it.
Yeah.
Probably train it really well, but you just won't get it.
No. I won't want to fuck you, it. Your wife? You won't get to the point where you want to fuck the dog, Rich.
Did your wife grow up with dogs?
Yeah.
Okay.
She wants
great.
Dogs.
So she, that's great. So you're more likely to get a whole bunch of different diseases when you're older. She won't, though. Read about that. They're great for oxytocin and you get such a buzz from each other. So if she's had them, she'll guide you through it. Okay. And you'll be walking it.
Yeah.
But that's great because you get to meet all the other dog walkers, and dog walkers are great. They're all people who are just going, this is my therapy. And when I bump into someone else, if we have to converse, it'll be about dogs. Nice and simple. Great way to connect. ease myself in, and what you don't want is anything going wrong. You know, like if the dog does something wrong, then it's conflict, and it's the opposite of why you're there. Mm-hmm. So if a Belgian...
Yeah, the Belgian. That was in the back of my mind.
Breaks the code of the dog walker? No.
We cut the UK off from the continent.
No, you take your dog back to fucking Belgium. I was wondering how to get back to that.
It was good. We got there.
Whew. I'm as tired and bored as you are. I've had enough also. But there was some great fun times.
There was.
This is my social. I've had a fabulous time.
It's been really lovely to have you.
Back to... This has been great.
I've enjoyed
having you. I don't want it to end, actually.
Okay.
But I do.
Okay.
I need to get back and start Googling Richards.
Yeah. You can email me a list later. We can read them out in a future podcast.
Like Richard. Nobody's called Richard anymore, apart from Dawkins and Dennett.
Dennett.
Daniel. That's one of my impressions of different stars.
Okay.
That's a white dwarf. Okay. This is our son. I want to say this is really good for a podcast, isn't it?
It is.
Here's the son.
He's thinking about which ones he can do. That's what I like. Which ones can I do?
This
Pluto.
What one's that?
Seemed unhappy.
Nebulae.
Oh.
I just was itchy there.
Yeah, that's fine.
And the moon. The moon's a. That's the moon. More?
Less.
You do this. Okay, do Jupiter.
I can do Uranus. That's the only one I can do. So. I'm hoping this podcast...
I was trying to set you up for that in the last 10 minutes.
Yeah. Back to William Herschel. It's all a cyclical,
can
well-planned
you cut this one,
thing.
Can you cut this one into two? So you
I'm trying to work out to cut it into half.
Because I really need to... I just cut this. I didn't listen to what you said, but I felt it. I got a feeling for what you said. I'm noticing stuff like that now. But
it's been amazing.
Did you mean that?
Yeah, no, it's been amazing. It's been
doesn't
amazing.
Matter anyway, because I'm going to keep talking. So my Edinburgh show.
Yeah.
So after doing 6 years in a row at lunchtime.
Yep.
You know, building up a following of people who maybe just are there to see if I'm all right. Probably. it just felt too crowded. Everyone started going on at lunchtime. I went out at lunchtime for, you know, child-rearing purposes. Yeah. I was the first. It was just me. And you slowly grab these people, you know? And then all of a sudden everyone's going, oh, I'm on at 11 now. And, you know, that's cool. And also that's like the funniest part of the day is the morning.
Yeah.
So this year I'm going on at night. And I'm having posters of my face.
Yeah.
And all that. So just when I've like destroyed the career, I'm going big. Posters and a huge empty room. So come along.
Yeah. We definitely.
And will. Then next year, 9 a.m. Boom! Noon? What have you been doing all morning? Mark my. Yeah, so 8 o'clock at night? 9 in the morning! Brilliant. So that was my plug-in.
Good, that is fantastic. Do go see Tony at the Edinburgh Fringe. He's there every year. He'll be back.
This year?
Yeah, this year, next year, every year.
Oh, and I'm here.
People will listen to this in the future. Where are you going to come in London? And...
Then I'm here in October.
Okay.
Here at the Leicester Square Theatre.
Leicester Square Theatre in October.
At
We might still
these
be
are reading glasses.
Let's just wait. Let's just fill the time. I've got reading glasses. I don't wear them, though.
So if I ever get on a panel show, like, right, I'm just do this. I don't know. So, you know, some of the stuff's just funny to me. Funny to me, because I kind of, I'll be doing this anyway, probably.
Yeah.
Well, this here, I'll be doing this at home.
Yeah.
Well, it's just never, I just keep doing this.
Yeah, let's go backstage and we'll carry on doing
I'll
it.
I'll carry, I'll probably follow you out. I'm reading things
You'll
well,
probably
though.
Probably follow me out.
I'll read it, though. I think nowadays, I'm going to read his, I'm going to be able to pick up when he wants me to go. I know it. The old Tony wouldn't have known, like, when enough's enough. Now I fucking know. Like, I'll feel it. I know he just wants more and it helps the show. I know that.
It does. Oh. Okay. Boy, I'm going to sleep tonight. It's been lovely to have you on, Tony. Tony Law is one of the funniest guys in the country. Give him a big round of applause. Thank you very much. We're back next time. We've got Lauren Laverne and Doc Brown next week. Come along and see that. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
How'd you like them sky potatoes?